niggas ain't nothing but fucking wolf, sell wolf chicken. Let me read this, we go back to that song, Bob the Shop. Isaiah 1 and 3. Our sinful nation. A people laden with iniquity.
Late. What does that mean, man? Late. You ever roasted a turkey and got the baster and sucked up some of the juice the turkey done extracted while it's cooking and you baste the turkey? You ever got you a plate of rice and got that ladle?
That big spoon, right.
And dipped out the gravy and ladle. Just laden with iniquity, man.
Iniquity is sin.
Just drenched in wickedness, man.
A seed of evildoers. Children that are corrupters. They are forsaking the Lord. They are provoking the Holy One of Israel into anger.
Right.
They are going away backwards. Who is that describing better than these so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man? Because the way you live, everything that you do, the path that you walk every day, is contrary to the law, statutes, commandments of your scripture, man.
That's right.
As well as scripture say that if you don't come back to your power and your nationality and follow these laws that's demanded, you're gonna be put to death, man.
Right.
That's why we're not out here for niggas, man. Because niggas not gonna take either the word. They gonna continue on to do what the fuck they gonna do, man.
Which is being niggas.
And talk shit across the street like a pussy instead of come handling his business like he said. He said he was gonna do something. All these people was out here. He ain't bust the brake, and I ain't gonna do shit, man. You niggas are just pussies, man. In fact, you should have been out here for the faggot parade last week. They would have put you on the goddamn thing and marched you through the goddamn street.
Right.
You fucking punk. You sissy. Now come here on the left, but you not.
Matter of fact.
Fucking weak ass nigga. Not only you niggas, but you crack too, man. There's no call way, man.
Right.
Not only him, but all these other nations, man. Hey, man, I don't know where, man. Where I'm from, niggas gonna stand across the street and make idle threats, man.
Right.
They come get it in or get the hell on, man.
They cackle like a broad.
A woman do that shit, man. A pussy. A real man come handle it, man.
And it ain't a lot of lip service.
No, labor. Very little lip service at all, man.
Is you that nigga? Oh, I'm that nigga. Here I am. Here I go. I'm going to bring this out. This is Jude, verse 18. How that they told you there should be markers in the last time.
Right.
Like we was telling the old cat that was up here earlier. This is it, man. This is the last time. How that they told us. Who told us? The prophets of old. Things that was written in the Old Testament.
Right.
Man. For all you that say the Old Testament is done away with.
Right.
That's baloney.
Right.
And so you can understand that's bullshit. How that they told you that, Shalak, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time who should walk after their own ungodly lust.
Woo! Ungodly! Ungodly. Let me bring this out real quick, brother. 2 Chronicles 36 and 16. But they mocked the messengers of God, and they despised his words, and misused his prophets, until the wrath of the Lord rose against his people, till there was no remedy.
Right.
So you ain't got to worry about it, man. You ain't got to worry about what we going to do, man. You got to worry about what the Most High Power of Israel going to do, man.
Right.
I'm going to read this again, man. But they mocked his message. They mocked the messengers of God and despised his words. Now let me tell you, how do you determine who are the messengers of God and who's not? Where did the scriptures tell you that you were going to find his men? Did they tell you they were going to find him in the church house?
Right.
Or out on the highways and byways?
Right.
The scriptures said the men of his loyal to go out on the highways and byways and bid those to the marriage as many as they can. We hearkening unto you. Commitment to you, telling you to come back to your power, come back to your nationality.
Right.
But you people, like you just said, Right. You won't listen.
We pipe
into a fold into you, but you won't dare. Scripture tells you're gonna find the men of the Lord out here on the highways and byways. So if you say we're not in the men of the Lord, who else is out here on the highways and byways? Where they at? Please point them up to me.
Right.
Priest Lil Don down on the highways and byways.
Shit. He ain't going nowhere without security. We in the midst of the elements, man. Ain't nobody up here. We ain't got no bodyguards up here. But we do have a faith that Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is our buckler, man. That he got our back. What's that, brother?
Turn.
Shit, 15 minutes to three. Come on. You know?
Not man. America's gonna be destroyed. All you pussy, lip-shaking, mama-ass niggas gonna be put to death.
Right.
Because I definitely see you ain't got the nuts to come over here and do nothing you said. So guess what that is? You're gonna be put to death right along with these red devils, the Edomites, the so-called white man. And we're gonna be out here every Saturday,
doing
the power
right.
of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
Hey man, guess what I got to say to you? Fuck you! Fuck all these niggas and fuck all these crackers out here, man. You shouldn't even be put to death. That's the furthest you gonna come. That's the furthest you gonna come, pussy. That's the furthest you gonna come, pussy. Hey, I'll double honor to the elders. He's the salutations to all you brothers out here pushing the word of the scripture tonight. That's right, man. A Bob, cut the camera, my brother. Shalom. Cut the camera. Cut the camera.